नमस्ते। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल पोंगल वाळ्त्तुकळ। इट्स हैप्पी मकर संक्रांति टुडे, राइट? एंड आई एम सो हैप्पी टू बिगिन अ जर्नी विद मायकथा टुडे विथ अ फोर्टनाइटली और लेट्स से अ मंथली स्टोरी टेलिंग। सो परहैप्स एवरी 15th आई ट्राई टू टेल यू अ स्टोरी। आई एम कॉलिंग इट स्टोरी जेम्स बिकॉज stories are so precious, isn't it? See this crow. Well, where did I see the crow? Oh, it's trying to tell me something. Yes, I know, it's reminding me of something. You know, this year, where how I began, every year I make it a point on New Year's to be at a beautiful place where there's a huge, big mountain. And this mountain has a shoulder. And if you look at this mountain, it's one of the oldest volcanic mountains. And when I go round that mountain, you're asking me if I can go around? Yes. It takes about 3.5 to 4 hours, and I see the mountain. It's covered with clouds, with mist, and sometimes it's green. Sometimes there's one mountain behind another mountain. Sometimes there's a group of mountains. So I wonder what this mountain is all about. It's always mysterious for me. And every time I see one or two birds, either a crow or a bird flying. And long ago, I got my first story from there. Well, that's another story. But I want to tell you who or where this mountain belongs. This mountain is called Thiruvannamalai, which means Annamalai. They also call it Arunachala. Aruna means light and Achala means still. They say Shiva and Shakti, they came together and became Ardhanarishvara. So it has a lot of energy, right? Okay, why am I telling you about this mountain? Because around, I think, 1879, there was a person who was born on this earth, and his name was Ramana. His actual name is Venkatraman, but they called him Ramana Maharishi. Well, this man, around that time when he was 16 years old, now you can calculate that, when it was, he came to only one place in his life. He took a train and he came straight to this Arunachala mountain, and he decided to go inside. There are two caves there, and he began to meditate. Now they say that he was there till the end of his life, which was almost in 1950 that he passed away. But let's not bother about the history of this person. When he came to this mountain, he saw this mountain and he decided to give up everything. He just wore like one langoti, he had a stick, and that's how he meditated and stayed. And he attracted a lot of people around the world. Okay, you're saying, okay, of all this, tell us a story. So a lot of people started coming, and out of that, there was one family who came from Coimbatore. And they had a son. His name was Ganesh. What I'm talking about is in 1920s. So this boy would come, and from the time he was a baby, they've been bringing him every year to this mountain. Now, you know, when you get used to a place, it's like your tata's place, right? So this boy came and he was about 8 or 9 years old, and every time he would wonder, every time he entered this ashram, if there's an ashram there, right? So every time he entered the ashram, he would hear Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala, Arunachala Shiva. Mummy, why they are singing this? Oh, they are singing in praise of Lord Shiva. Oh, and then he would peep, and in one hall there will be people closing their eyes and What is that, mummy? Why are they closing their eyes, mummy? Mummy, why? What, ma, amma, why are they folding? They're sitting down. And why is? What is Ramana Maharishi, Tata doing there? He's also closing his eyes. No, everyone is closing his eyes. It's called meditation. Meditation, ah. What is meditation, mummy? Closing your eyes. Remember, I told you a story how Prahlad closed his eyes and Dhruva closed his eyes and they closed their eyes and said, Om Namo Narayanaya. Yeah, but they were chanting, no, mummy. Yeah. But these people are very quiet. How do they know? How do you know? You want to sit? You want to sit, Ganesh? Asked his mother. Yes, mummy, but when I sit, I'm so restless. I don't know what is meant. Wait, I close my eyes. Ah, I can see one monkey. And that time, a monkey was looking at Ganesh. And at the same time, the monkey came quickly past Ganesh. And there was one gunda of water. So, he took that. He drank the water and he ran away. See how that monkey came, he was concentrating, he drank the, that is only meditation. Goma, that's not meditation, but he didn't have his eyes closed. Oh, I don't know what, how to explain to this boy. Don't ask me questions, but mommy, you're not telling me. You're not listening. Mommy, I'm listening, but I can't understand. Okay, wait. Now be quiet because everyone is closing their eyes and we have to go for our breakfast. And Ganesh was also feeling hungry. And the meditation got over. And from the hall, everyone came. And who came with them? Tata. Who is this Tata? Ramana Maharishi. So Ramana came. And he was chatting with a few people. But he's generally very quiet. You know, he used to cut vegetables. He used to serve. So, Ramana Tata was ready and they all were going towards the kitchen. Now, Ganesha also came with Tata. And on the way, Ramana Tata said, you know, today you sit opposite to me, okay? And you eat. When will you listen to me? Tata, I will, said Ganesh. Now, they went inside the dining hall. And everyone was put the banana leaf to eat. And Ramana Tata sat and opposite Ganesh sat. Now, will you listen, Ganesha? Yeah, yes, Tata, tell me. Can you smell the dosa? Because he was also hungry. His mother and father sat on either side of Ganesh. Now, Ramana Tata said, see, they're going, when they serve the dosa, you eat slowly, okay? We are not in any competition. But you just listen to what I have to say. I'm just going to say, and you start eating. Okay. Then you eat at your own pace. I will just, you have to listen, okay? Sure, Tata. I'll do another, and that time you stop. Okay, Tata. He said he was very excited. Nice game, he thought. And now he sat down and sudha, the dosa was served. And Ramana began to eat slowly. But before he began to eat, he looked at Ganesh. Ganesh was looking at Tata. Now Tata looked at Ganesh and said, And Ganesh began to eat that dosa. He loved that dosa. He dipped it in chutney, dipped it in sambar. But every time he was having the dosa, he looked at Tata. Again, when he was having the dosa, he was looking at Tata. So all the time that he was eating, he was looking at Ramana Tata. Ramana Tata was just smiling and eating. Now the last bit of the dosa, only one piece was left. And as he was about to eat, Ramana Tata smiled and did, and he swallowed that last bit. He was so happy. He said, Tata, see, I listened to you. He said, yeah. So, were you looking at dosa, Ganesha? A little bit. were you looking? So where was your mind? Tata, I was only looking at you because I was only waiting for that sound to come from you. So all the time you were concentrating on me, no? Yeah. Okay, now that is called meditation. What? I said, see, all the time you concentrate on me. Just imagine if you concentrate on God like this, but go on with your activity. So you play, you run, you do your homework, but your concentration is all the time on God. That is all that meditation is all about. Then why do they close their eyes, Tata? Well, that's because they want to go deeper. That when you grow up, when you do it, it's more than enough. Hiya. Then he went to wash his hands and both the parents came and thanked Ramana for giving such a beautiful example. Wait, Ramana said, I have something more to add. Chulungo, tell us, said the parents. And he said, you remember the first that is birth. You remember the last time, the second time when I did that is death. So between birth and death, whatever activity you do, you just concentrate on God. Oh, they thought it was such a wonderful message. They thanked him, and by the time Ganesh came back and they left after praying to the altar on the samadhi of his mother, and they left. And as they left, Ganesha came back running and said, Tata, Tata, will you tell me that story, that monkey you were telling last time? Oh, and the Nundi Koranga, which means lame monkey, is it? Yeah, why does that monkey come and always sit with you and doesn't bite you at all? That's another story. Next time when you come, I will tell you that story, okay? Okay, Tata. I was very excited. Amma, Amma, when will we come back again? Mummy was very happy. And she took him and they got into the bus. And as they were crossing that mountain and they left the ashram, he heard the song. Om Namo Ramanaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Sri Ramanaya. Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala. Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala Shiva, Arunachala. Ganesha was also singing, and as he crossed the bus, he was waiting when to come back again to this beautiful big mountain. Then he heard a crow and he saw a bird coming towards the mountain, and the crow was trying to circle. As if it was telling a story to that mountain. Well, I think it's a good beginning, isn't it? And we have been meditating, but I think it's a beautiful time to contemplate, to reflect. And we have to start young. So Ganesha went on to come every now and then to the ashram. And he met Ramana Tata until he died. In 1950, they say they saw a shooting star in the sky when he died. He was a great soul. So I went there for this New Year's, and I keep going back to the mountain. Because as I told you, my first story came from the mountain. And it's the first story in my book, which is going to be released on January 24th by Penguin. Arunachala Shiva. Namaste.